We got a new sponsor, gents.
Part of the day. I poop, she poops, all women poop. I'm a woman and I poop.
I'm a woman and I poop.
I'm a woman and girlfriend? I poop regularly.
Thanks for the poop empowerment.
Dude, that's Rosie O'Donnell.
Oh, are we talking about my vagina now?
Oh, what the fuck? Start the show.
The dream I've broken, seen that all was lost. Would you be the future? Could you pay the cost? You won. Will there ever be a second time around?
Oh, when it's over and the moment has come. Say, my Lord, I think I found someone. And no one would be better than putting it together for the second time around.
Step by step, day by day, a fresh start over, a different hand to play. Deeper we fall, the stronger we stay. We'll be better, second time around.
Hey, what's up? What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? We're live here at the Crew Network Studios in Highland, California.
East Highland.
And if you're a redneck on Facebook, it's most likely DK Murphy. He is here in studio right now, live. You could come over here and kick his ass free of charge.
Free of charge.
Eastbound and down.
But he also has a kissing booth, which is not free.
Oh, yeah. He does have a kissing booth.
I don't think many people want to kiss me because, you know, they might catch something.
Yeah, but
like
still available.
What are we talking about?
Never mind.
Oh, disgusting.
It's all mystery.
So, I mean, like I said, we got a new sponsor. It's Women's a Poop. You know, women's vagina. That's important shit.
I love it.
And, you know, Lux Bidets, we do have a new launch that our production guy here just sent over to me. And there is a new launch. We'll talk about that more in the middle of this show. But first and foremost, talking about shitting on people, welcome, DK Murphy.
Welcome back
to the show. Okay.
Hi, guys.
So I guess Kentucky Fried Mike was on last week.
Sure was.
And completely shit on you.
Yeah.
So you did tell me that you said you were really pissed. It seemed like you were laughing your ass off, but you're also pretty pissed off.
I'm going to say it like this. So, yes, I laughed my ass off listening to you guys. I was legit at work, and I start belly laughing when you guys are talking about the dicks.
Yeah.
My coworker comes up to me and he goes, "What's so funny, Joe?" And I just look up and I go, "My friends are monsters."
What did we say about the dicks? I don't even remember.
See, okay.
We were gone, dude.
You remember you were like, "My dick's so big, you know, it could run for Congress."
Oh, yeah. My dick pay half the rent.
Yeah. But, no, then I noticed that, like, then he starts shitting, like, actually shitting on me.
Oh, he did, yeah.
Oh, we were laughing about that. Yeah. The hypocrisy.
And I was like, "Oh, really, fool?" So I listened to it two more times to take down notes.
Get your alcohol ready. Get it ready.
Yes. Oh, by the way, every time I prove a fucking point that he over-exaggerated like a motherfucker. Mm-hmm.
What is it?
I'm going to take a shot. This is his
penis
cheap
size.
Vodka.
Some cheap ass vodka. He over-exaggerated his penis
that
size.
That is some cheap ass vodka. That's in plastic
container. It's in plastic, dude. Yeah. That's fucking nasty. Even Russians.
That's
like,
fucking nasty.
That's because that shit will get you so fucked up. The last thing they want is for you to bust it over the thing.
Yeah, even the Russians fucking look down upon that vodka.
Yeah.
That's the vodka they torture victims with.
Exactly. They don't give it to their bears.
That's the one they used to throw at people.
I first off want to say to Chuck, tell your friend that I apologize that I don't acknowledge him. You are totally right because I am not a social butterfly. But when I'm at work,
I was trying to think of all these things he said.
You're a social moth.
Yeah. But I see so many faces, and most of them are still wearing masks.
More of a social capitalist.
I just don't know.
He wrote down all his goddamn points.
Yeah.
Oh, he's going to retrace all this shit. I don't remember any of this goddamn shit we talked about.
Okay. Yes.
Okay.
That's hilarious.
All right.
Well, I don't want to take up the full episode, but I mean, give me like 5 minutes and please.
How many shots are
you at? SG.
Look, you got it. You got it.
I'm talking about you. I need you to please not interrupt too much.
Ooh.
Just me. It's always just me.
Just
you. Because you do it the most.
Okay. Ooh.
All right.
I think it's because you're Mexican.
So now I want to talk. I want to talk about.
He's racist. Yeah.
Fucking racist.
I want to talk about Eric Draven, the Crow. Sorry, I mean your brother. I always get those two confused.
And I really wish you would stop, because the truth is, it can't rain all the time.
Is this a roast?
Yeah. No.
Still not funny.
No, because I was listening. I was still listening to it, and he started off like normal, but then it became like this. I'm this tortured soul thing. I'm a victim.
Like, bro, if you bomb like that one more time, I'm going to have to call the FBI.
Just kidding. Get out of here,
asshole. All right.
We're going to notify New York.
So check this out. The Rocky friendship. What the fuck does that mean?
It means that you guys barely have a friendship.
I think what it means is, and I'll tell you right now. So hold on to your britches.
Okay.
Stinky britches.
Hold on to your lug nuts. Time for an overhaul.
Let's hear this.
Yeah.
All right. I think that when you get his chicks, that he it basically says that he let go of them or couldn't hold on to them, and then you get a hold of them.
I don't give a fuck.
It basically is telling him that they moved on to bigger, better things. So, as some men may take it like, "Oh, you got my sloppy seconds." Well, other people are looking at it like, "Yeah, but she kind of left you for him." So, if you're talking shit DK, you got to kind of. Yeah. Except you that know, also you're talking bigger shit on yourself.
I always just thought we were friends. Not as close as I am with you guys, but like Rocky friendship.
Yeah, exactly.
Like over exaggeration.
Why is it so wet?
Toast.
This shit.
Oh, there we go. Oh, wait. That's water.
That's water. Yeah, you got to get the alcohol. Get the scotch. You're Irish.
Go. Not right now.
Oh.
Damn.
You know, in Ireland, this...
I'm not Irish right now. Yeah. I'm white
Scotland. Yeah. And in Ireland, this podcast was turned off. It was ended
so
when
you guys
that.
Got the bus story wrong, and I couldn't believe that.
What bus story?
He got it wrong, then. He told
the
story.
We weren't there.
You guys know. You guys were talking about it.
But we brought it up.
He brought it up.
So, yeah, check it out. Yeah. No. You brought it up.
Did he?
Yes.
Well, we weren't there, so clarify it.
Okay, so from your guys' point of view, it sounded like, you know how people... will hear about, oh, there was a heated argument, and then someone will want to repeat the story, but they'll tweak it to make it sound more
impressive.
Like
you guys were on the bus together, and that there was some kind of a jerk over at Walmart.
You're a badass right now, bro.
And then he was like, I don't know. You tell
Here's
us.
What happened. So we get off the bus, and we're about to cross the street.
Yeah.
Across the street is a junkie who I'm constantly having to kick out of Walmart. Who said several times you want to kick my ass?
So you have a former relationship with this junkie.
I'm constantly kicking him out.
So he knows your face.
Yes, he knows me.
This is before COVID.
Yes, this is like 2 years ago.
God damn it.
Yeah, that was that junkie that kept on harassing him. Yeah.
Okay.
So I don't have any weapons. I don't have my partner. I'm actually not on Walmart property yet, so I'm kind of fucked.
And no face mask to protect you.
This is, again, before COVID.
Exactly.
So I think to myself...
That was over 2 years ago.
Yeah. I look over at Mike thinking, you got a friend in me, but I guess I fucking didn't. Jesus.
You looked at him or did you ask him?
Here's what happened.
He did a wink.
We're walking and the guy's getting closer and closer. And I just say, hey, man, this guy wants to fight me. You got my back. Now, if he said no, I didn't hear him. luckily for me, the guy
he's like, I'm right behind you.
Yeah, exactly.
See you there.
Behind you.
And you know, Tim was there, and Tim said he's got a gun.
Oh,
and
shit.
I look.
He's got a gun, man.
I turn back around, and he flashes his fucking gun.
He said,
"Well, Tim, Tim's street smart. Tim ain't trying to get killed for nobody."
Well, I don't care. I wasn't asking Tim. I was asking somebody I considered a friend.
You chose Mike over Tim?
Yeah, and let me know.
I didn't see Tim until after.
I'm like, well, you fucked up in that fight.
We're walking.
Dude, what's the coincidence that all three of these fuck nuts are on one bus?
No, Tim was across the street.
What the fuck were you going to? One fucking time.
And the junkie was there. Guys, we didn't make this story up.
Yeah. Now, he was on the podcast, and he said, I wasn't going to help him.
Yeah.
And then he had said, how is it loyalty to bring me into a fight? That's what you fucking do with your friends, you know? You don't fucking ditch them.
You don't ditch them, but he also don't try to bring him into a fight.
I wasn't asking to bring... Okay.
He asked if he could back him up.
Yeah.
Because this dude's got a fucking mic come at him.
Okay, but...
Back me up.
Okay. So before you saw the gun, you asked Mike, hey, you got my back?
Yeah, this is before we saw the gun.
Okay, so that's different. So it's trying to different line. Yeah. So Mike basically led you on that he had your back. And then
he never said anything, but yeah.
Well, you know, physical.
He did like the whole, whatever.
He was right next to me.
Yeah. So he acted
he
like.
He should have said something.
And then, okay, so let me ask. when Tim said, they got a gun, or he's got a gun.
He's got a gun.
If he, when he said that, did Mike's physical demeanor change?
I don't know, because at that point, I didn't see him again.
That motherfucker, as soon as he heard gun or back me up,
so he
that motherfucker went to the back. You know how there's two fucking doors that open in the bus?
Yeah.
That motherfucker went out the window.
Yeah, he bitched out.
The third fucking kick out.
This is taking place literally in the middle of the street. So now, when I was hearing him say that, like, I wasn't going to back him up, I thought that the scenario... So, okay, you and me who are supposed to be friends...
What by any chance, and not that it matters, what was the color of this man who had a gun?
Mexican?
Oh,
Mexican.
Oh, Mexican, huh?
Yeah. Now,
yes. Okay. And what was the... Why did he hate you again?
Because he kept shoplifting and I had to kick him out.
What a douche.
Yeah.
No, that's a douche on him, dude. Fuck that.
Yeah, he was a junkie.
It was
even more so, dude.
Yeah.
What a piece of shit. I'm on your side again.
Yeah, like.
But you know, maybe he was a friend of Kentucky Mike's. Fried Mike's.
Of a junkie.
Wait, but a junkie with a gun, dude? That's a successful junkie.
He had just gotten that gun, or at least that was the first time I saw him with a gun.
No, but you know, dude,
he stole enough shit from Walmart to get the gun.
Yeah that's what I mean, though, dude. Most junkies just sell shit.
Yeah, he's a hustler, junkie. Yeah.
Now just think about like what Mike said. Like,
kids sell so many cookies, this junkie stole so much shit. He rewarded,
dude. That's the last level. So basically, what would have happened if, you know, Mike said no is, okay, this guy's, what if this guy kicks my ass? What's Mike going to do? Just walk away? Oh, that's peculiar. See you, Joe. Oh, what a lovely friend you are.
I think you're right. So you're saying that it says more that he's a pussy than a friend.
Yeah, of course he's a pussy.
Also, because remember, then he was like, I wanted to bash, his head in with a brick.
Yeah, steer a little bit, man. There you go.
Yeah, he said he wanted to bash my head in with a brick when he first met me. So how is it better that it's okay to bash my head in with a brick, but 2-on-1 against a junkie? No, fuck that. I'm above that. Fuck you.
I see that.
Yeah, and also, hey, what would have happened if like. The guy actually pulled out the gun and shot me. What would Mike have done then?
That's a risk he was willing to take.
Just, bam. That's the risk we were willing to take.
It's like, bam. Oh, no, I'm late for work. Fuck, man.
What a douche. Yeah. Hey, so now you know he'll never have your back.
Yeah. And I would just like to let you know, Michael, I would have helped you if it was you getting in the fight.
Ooh, bitch ass motherfucker.
Now, this is where he went to actually insulting me.
Kentucky Fried Mike.
Yes, Kentucky Fried Mike. Because he said, you know, I helped him on his, for lack of a better term, movie.
Yeah, and Kentucky I was like, Fried Mike.
How many movies have you done, Mike? Oh, none? Yeah, but you had a good day.
He did do one.
Yeah.
There was what was it?
It was like with the elderly black gay guy.
Yeah.
And he was
called
the bottom.
Kentucky.
It was the bottom.
Kentucky Fried Buck.
Yeah, Kentucky Fried Dick. But so check this out. I timestamped this just because I was like, really, motherfucker. This is what he said this.
He's serious. The majority of the listens.
Yeah. I'm helping him big time. I'm helping him with everything. I mean, everything needs to get set up. I'm the guy doing it.
Ooh.
Over fucking exaggeration.
He did everything. He said he did everything.
Let me ask you a question. So I paid him to basically help me. Now,
cheeseburgers.
No, I gave him money.
God damn it.
Well, there's a lot more I actually gave him.
Okay.
But I want you to guess. How long do you think he actually was physically working? Take a guess.
Probably like an hour, knowing him.
Yeah, out of how many hours? Like, how long was he there?
We were there
but how long was he there? 6 hours?
From like 10 to 8.
Two.
Okay, two, one, Chuck.
What are you talking about?
Just pick a number between 0 and 8.
7.
Okay, here's how long he actually physically worked. 20 minutes.
Damn.
He spent the rest of the day smoking cigarettes in the corner.
Mm-hmm.
So, again, over fucking exaggeration.
Did he try hooking up with any of your... with your
hey, that's cast. Most Hollywood, though, you guys. You're still paying for time. You got to think about that.
Yeah, hey, but didn't you fuck his ex-girlfriend?
Twice, right? Didn't you fuck a few of them?
A couple times?
A few of them?
All of them?
The goth-looking ones.
Yeah.
That's all of them.
All of them. Oh, that's the only ones he had. Does he have one?
Well, that's not the only one.
Artie has one now, like on a stick. Like she has a stick as a leg. Yeah. That's what I heard. I don't know if that's real.
Really?
I never met her.
Oh, he says something like that. I don't know.
Is that real?
He says something like
that. She's peg leg?
We got to get him
a peg
on.
Leg.
Yeah, we had to get him on to clarify.
He's fucking a pirate.
You know why? Her dad was a tree.
Now, he said, I don't have to be there, but I was there. Yes, you fucking
I don't know. Is that real?
Stop barking.
Does she really have one leg?
Yeah.
That's fucked up, man.
She does. Oh, now you feel bad.
And how dare you guys make fun of her?
I know.
It was Lou told me this joke. I just didn't say it.
Fucking pieces of shit.
Now, I paid him. And listen, when I pay for a whore, I pay her to suck my dick, not suck my dick and tell me what it tastes like. Thank you, Michael.
Damn. Ooh.
No. You know why I actually
You're calling all the exes whores?
No, I'm talking about him.
You pay him?
I paid him to work for me. Did you? Are you not paying attention?
Are you not fucking paying attention?
Here's the dick suck part.
Pissing Lou off.
Yes. Now, you know why I actually picked him to work for me?
Because he works for cheeseburgers. Because
he makes you look cute.
No, because he wasn't working at the time. I was trying to help him out.
Oh, what, to help you move?
No, it was to help. He was a grip, basically. I needed him to, you know, move stuff around.
A penis grip.
He's grabbing that dick.
Yeah, he was a fluffer.
A penis grip.
Oh, okay, yeah.
But he wasn't working, as he said that, you know, Roundtable was giving him shit hours. So I'm like, let me give this guy some money, and it at least helps.
Is that really where your thoughts came from?
I'm hand to God.
Oh wow,
hand to God.
So hey, Kentucky Fried Mike, you are a piece of shit.
You're over exaggeration.
You're a believer. Yep. I forgot.
Kentucky Fried Mike is a lazy to that. Piece of shit.
Yeah. In this point of view. He could have
just only worked 5 hours a day.
Yeah. Just last night.
Yeah, he's exhausted. Five fucking hours.
Just last night, Kentucky Fried Mike was seen eating, and I record this shit. I'm telling you guys, it's going to be a big. But on TikTok, there is footage of this man eating his own chicken. He swore he wouldn't eat.
Oh, you mean the cotton chicken?
The cotton-laced chicken.
Popcorn chicken.
The cotton-laced chicken. The
fucking My Pillow chicken.
Now, you know what he didn't
My
say?
Pillow chicken version.
You know what he didn't say happened, though?
No.
Which, of course, because he had to be the victim.
If you want to talk to him, he's right here.
All right.
He's not where the Billy Idol is.
Not only did I pay him, I bought him lunch. I bought him a beer, and we all hung out afterwards. But according to him, he looked at me with disdain.
Do you think that he's jealous of your penis size?
Probably.
Are you reading a script?
No, I have notes, motherfucker.
Same thing. Same thing.
And I have no idea what he meant when I said he looked at me with disdain. I had bigger fish to fry. I was not mad at him the day. What the fuck are you talking about? I looked at you with disdain.
When you say bigger fish, do you mean that fat vagina on that girl that you're going to fuck that day?
Always.
Nice.
Well, no, you know, so like according to him, I'm setting up the shot. I'm giving my actors the motivation.
Mm-hmm.
Action. Cut. And then I just look at Mike like, you piece of shit.
And by motivation, these are BJs. HJs. Exactly.
Well, more fluffing. That's what he was there for.
Okay, it depends on their age.
I'm saying.
If they're under 18,
maybe
then
he's upset because there wasn't enough cheeseburgers.
I know.
It was like blowjob. Blowjob,
Betty.
And then cheeseburger. Maybe he wanted a cheeseburger between every two blowjobs.
Now, this is the last thing, but then I got some stuff I want to tell you guys, not just everyone else. So he had said our friendship is rocky is because I don't give a fuck. How is that my problem? What does that mean?
Damn fighting words.
What does that mean that you don't give a fuck, so our friendship is rocky? That doesn't make any sense.
Do you think Maniacal Michael or Kentucky Fried Mike will fight DK at Booze Mania?
No, definitely not.
Definitely not.
No. I think he'll talk about it. And then we'll have to make him.
He'll talk about it, but unless there's enough money in it for it, he won't do it.
Just like right. Backyard wrestling.
What
just
if like I promise him like two buckets of chicken and a joint?
No, 40 bucks. He can still buy
a chicken. In 40 bucks.
He can steal chicken.
Well, okay, dude, that's $40 an hour. That's like a director.
But I've got something for you guys. I want to give you guys points. Because you guys fucking had me dying of laughter, including Mike. So
yeah, Mike was funny.
Yeah, he was. That's what I'm saying.
Now,
we all
points
are.
To all of you guys.
Funny.
Sorry,
it's mostly because of us.
Fucking awesome.
Exclusive. What?
Sorry.
Points to all you guys for those dick jokes because those were fucking hilarious and they were coming.
Which
constantly.
Ones? Do you remember?
No. Penis jokes.
Just, you know, like my dick pays after rent. My dick makes has social security. Everyone made a good joke.
Those aren't jokes. Those are facts, bro.
Them facts.
Points for Mike for the. His ass was eating those bicycle shorts.
Oh, dude. Oh, that shit was so fucking funny.
Even I was like, fuck.
Oh, yeah, was dude, I remember fun. When you made that FUD, when you were harassing Mark, and Mark walked away, you're like, look at that ass eating those bicycle shorts. That's all I could think of, dude.
Now, points to Sassy for...
Me up a little bit.
Points to Sassy for Joe looks like he smells like gym balls. I heard that and I was like, oh my God.
You smell like a gym locker room.
Yeah, that was funny.
Now,
gym balls.
I'm going to throw just a little shade at
you guys all still
Kentucky
here?
Fried
yeah.
because he threw shade at me with that fucking comment about, you know, for lack of a better term, a movie. So this is Joe Smells.
Yeah.
Joe Smells. Joe also has a full-time job. Joe Smells. Joe has a car. Joe smells. Joe doesn't live in a garage. And Joe smells. Joe fucks all of your exes.
That was like a poem.
It's a poem.
Yeah, I kind of like it. I kind of like the haiku.
I think you should get that. I think Mike should get that tattooed on his abs. Well, he doesn't have abs.
His flabs.
What's that one guy's name?
Get on that second good.
He's dating his mom?
James.
Yeah, what's
James.
His name? Hamana.
James, tell your mom I'm on my way.
Oh, yeah.
That's good stuff.
You know, I'm not angry at him, and I'm not going to hate him, but I'm definitely going to be looking at him in a different light. You know.
Damn.
Rough stuff.
Telling me I had bad jokes. Like, yeah.
Hey, you didn't get down into that like you should have.
Yeah, I thought you were going to reach the label.
We should definitely roast Mike.
Over exaggeration. Oh, we should.
There you go.
That'll be fun.
Oh, with Mike.
Anybody else got
easy.
Any hate?
We slayed
him.
He'd be dead.
No kidding.
Who else is that?
I got some. So I went to this inspection the other day, and it was all the way in thermal. I was like, fuck, I usually don't go out to thermal, but this guy
said,
he texted me. He said, hey, I had a stroke, so this is the only way I can communicate. So I felt bad for him. He took me out. He said, this is the only way I could communicate. So I felt bad for the guy because usually I don't go that far for inspections, right?
So you.
So I go out there and it's at a mobile home. It's at the Salton Sea. And if anybody knows about the Salton Sea, it's it's fucking hood. So basically, all these people.
It's a fucking fart test.
All these people were promised.
Smells like shit.
All these people were promised beachfront property. So they bought these trailers next to the, you know, the Salton Sea.
Fucking
tards. And it's so fucking polluted that even the fish die in this fucking water.
Yep.
So, well, you know why it's polluted, right?
I guess because a bunch of fucking nuclear warheads.
No.
Because all the Ukrainians wash their feet.
In that river.
And the Bundys.
Yeah.
No, there's a giant sulfur deposit underneath it.
Yeah, right underneath it. That's what kept the water warm, but at the same time, it dried out.
Yeah. All the Euclideans washed your feet. The
all the Murphys, thank you.
All the Murphys. My bad. Yeah.
All the Murphys.
Come on, man.
No. So this guy, basically, I get there, and this guy, you know, there's these dogs at the gate. I'm like, come on, dude. Like, I text him. I say, hey, listen, I'm at the front. Hounds. So this guy comes out like this, and I felt bad for him. He had like a limp, but all he had, he was super fucking hairy. He looked like Eddie's dad.
Damn.
Wait. Do you mean like
Eddie's dad? Eddie's real dad.
Okay, his real dad.
Eddie's real fucking dad.
I don't remember that guy.
That guy looks like Gallagher.
So
Gallagher.
This guy's basically bald, but he's got long hair at the edge here. But he's got a bald. You know, he's got an executive cut.
That's Eddie's.
And then he's hairy everywhere, right?
Yep.
So dude's only wearing a pair of shorts.
Ew.
Only a pair of shorts, no underwear. So this dude comes out and he shows me, he's like, and the problem is here, it is ants. I'm like, I thought it was termites. He's all, in that termites, it ants. And then so he
grown up Bobby Boucher.
Goes towards
Bobby Boucher.
I know, fucked up.
He goes towards and throws it away.
He goes towards the problem, and as he's walking, his fucking shorts are falling down, and all I'm seeing
just
is his
like Eddie.
Hairy fucking ass, right? And I'm like, oh my goodness.
That's hilarious.
And like it's down to a point where like I'm seeing dick root.
Yeah,
where I'm like,
I like,
dude, do you want me to pull up your shorts for you?
Yeah,
like,
oh, you told him that.
I'm almost at that point.
That's how bad it was.
That's how bad it was.
Do you need me to fucking?
I'm almost at the point.
I'll build something right now.
I'm, hey, dude, do you want me to pull up your fucking shorts?
Yo, I got wires
because you know your dick's about to pop out.
Yeah, I got suspenders.
He's all, nah, dude, it's little. It's
I didn't say anything though. I just said, listen, dude, I don't think we could help you. He's all, what? I'm all, you gotta call. You got to call like somebody else because this is too far out. I thought it was for termites. You know, we can't do continuous work out here. It's too far. He's like.
He goes, that guy,
okay.
I'll tell you that. He's like, they're going to eat me alive.
Yeah. No, he even told me the trail. He's like, they're coming from there to over here to over into my bed.
Yo, well, stop him at one of those fucking points. He
sounds like Dusty Rhodes was the client.
It's like, it's
sir,
like
get a can of Raid.
How am I going to sell a job for $2,000 when the whole house is worth less?
He looks over. Sir, that TV is from 1950. Have you heard of Raid? He's all, With a raid.
You know these come in color, right? And he's like, I don't like the colors.
I can see those houses from the road, and you're like, yeah, those look like shit.
Dude, I kind of just wanted to piss on the house just because.
If you pissed on the ant trail, you would have helped him.
I know.
He wouldn't have done anything.
The color would have
And no one would have believed him.
Better.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, if I just whipped out my dick and started pissing on everything.
Exactly.
Nothing would have happened.
No one would have
ever he probably would have pissed
right
off.
On the carpet.
He would have probably tried to blow you or some shit.
You're right. Yeah. The other one, he would like.
He would have been like, oh, we're doing that now.
Like, oh, my shorts are loose for a reason.
Here we go.
Look at day.
You fell for the oldest trick of the book, son.
Hey, this didn't really happen, though, right?
For work wise. It's all ripped.
Can't really talk about, but I didn't mention any names, so I'm safe, right?
Yeah.
It
happened.
Like,
you really
like I fucking care.
It happened one time at one of the jobs you've had of what? Fuck, you work like 20 jobs by now.
So I'd like to take a commercial break right now. I'm going to give this sponsor a try. Just leave things running.
Oh, okay.
I did. Our marketing guy here, Dick Sassy, he got a new, he got something from Lux Bidets. And now,
where'd they get you?
Now they have a camera controlled remote app on the iOS and Android.
Wow.
It turns colors and releases a fragrance that smells like.
Really? It smells like roses. It smells like caramel.
Barbecued ribs.
They have like 10 different scents, so you could
barbecue
pick your own.
Ribs.
Yeah, I'm sure you could write in. These guys are great. They're geniuses.
Long story short, you want to hang out in the bathroom when you're done. Yeah.
Next time I take a shit, you want to go in there right after.
You're like, oh my God.
You know,
mesquite?
Not many people could say that, but if you own a Lux Bidet, that's amazing.
Come on, everybody. Spend the extra $100. Fucking like, clean your ass the right way.
Lux Bidets, they're fantastic. It's truly like, when you have the high pressure, the PSIs go too high, they kind of give you an enema.
Yeah.
And then you clean out all the shit.
I thought that was the point, actually. Yeah.
No, really?
I suck it in and spit it out.
It's like a penis-sized enema.
Nice.
A penis-sized enema.
I wouldn't say that, but I mean, like, yeah, it's just a stream of water going in.
Right up your ass, and then you just shit it out.
Clean the fuck out of my colon, dude.
I'm going to demonstrate what it sounds like.
Go for it. Oh, mine's more of like
perfect.
Yeah.
Like mine's like full on jet and shit.
Oh. Oh yeah. But what about when it enters your asshole?
Yeah, oh, it's going then. Like how you
Yeah. That's my so you start the jet. Do the jet part.
Oh.
There we go, and that's what it sounds like.
Do you remember the wrestler
Back
Genius?
To your regular scheduled program.
Oh no, remember Les Bidet, the
everybody. Fucking buy one.
Lenny Poffo, the genius.
Yeah, that's Randy Macho Savage's Man's brother.
Yeah, he lives by those
Lux Bidets.
Yeah, he lives.
Oh, that's because he's the genius.
Yeah, he's the genius. He said on camera.
He uses it as
my
fucking water pick.
My asshole is cleaner than yours.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I bet you that piece of shit uses it on his face. He fucking puts it up. He uses a fucking water pick and shit like that.
Also, too.
Does yours have the cleaner setting? Where like it cleans itself? Where it drips water on it hard? Like mine has multiple settings.
Yeah. That's one. Yeah. Mine does all the shit.
Oh, yours is the heat one and everything
too? Tip Top Magoo. No. I ain't got no heat. Anyways, look up something for me, young Jamie.
What are we doing? What are we
looking at? Go to, let's see. Popstar Nima. I don't know. On YouTube.
Okay.
Popstar Nima asshole.
Oh, okay.
We're waiting.
So he uses the Lux Bidet too, and I think he wrote a song.
This guy came into work today, and he looked like if Hulk Hogan had AIDS.
That's a good man.
Yeah.
Did you get his autograph?
No,
but asshole.
I said the Hulkster, asshole. And he looked at me like, huh?
Yeah. Now put that video on. We're gonna do some commentating here. Is it clean up my asshole? He made this because he has a bidet.
It says my asshole.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Cleaning out my asshole, I wanted to.
I'm trying to get this guy on the show so fucking bad. Yeah.
Cleaning out my asshole, I don't want a disaster.
Why is it hard to get him on?
Because when you clean out your asshole, he doesn't want a disaster. He's real considerate.
Whoa, those people came out of his asshole. They just jumped right out.
They're not in sync at all.
I almost want to say that, like,
it's a disaster.
I want to say Dick Sassy can pull this off for Halloween.
Dude,
if you are this guy for Halloween, I'm just telling you now that you're going
to
win everything.
You have to sing the song, though. Yeah, you can't just show up.
You will win everything.
And that's a cheap, right, for sure. That's a cheap costume.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, he got the color to match his eyes. I get it. He gives
I like that you're looking at his eyes.
Yeah, dude, why am I looking at his fucking non-dick?
No, I just feel like looking at the face.
All right. That's enough of this.
Okay. Fucking. Right?
What is
his name?
So that's pop star Nima. I'm trying to get him on the show. And
why?
His, so you know, he tucks. He says he tucks.
He
says it comes out as a giant fucking mangina. You have to tuck. But you know, every time I think of Lux Bidets, that's like the theme song for the Lux Bidets. Is that I'm cleaning out my asshole. I want to avoid a disaster.
Is that what you're singing to yourself when you do it?
Yeah. I'm actually gonna build that into the song as the Lux Bidet shoots.
When you turn it,
asshole.
It fucking sings. That'd be pretty cool, dude.
So no, I should be as you flush and then
as you flush
and then.
I wanna make it work for you.
How often do you listen to this?
A lot.
Because like you know the song, I'm all like,
I know the whole album.
Gay.
I know the whole fucking album.
How did you
find
this guy?
This is like me and my brother-in-law. This is like our fucking relief as far as laughing.
This is your jam.
This is the funniest shit ever.
So you and your brother-in-law look up gay shit. All right.
Big time.
Just big time.
Okay, cool.
Him, military people. This is real big amongst the military people. Alpha males.
Well, they
laugh
are,
their ass off.
Yeah, trans are allowed there.
Bucks and his brother-in-law eventually pull out their dicks and start jerking off to it.
Right?
Jerking each other off.
There's tons of people that listen to this.
It's not called circle jerk. It's called line jerk.
It's not manly. It's
line jerking.
Because
country is country, so they're line jerking each other. Yeah.
I don't know about that. Let's edit that out.
You think they're circle jerking?
I don't want to come off gay.
You don't want to come off as gay watching this shit.
No,
you are gay.
No.
You're
that's
gay
a very manly
this?
Video.
This
fuck
is
yeah,
a
dude.
Manly video.
He's singing about his asshole.
No, he's encouraging men to clean their asses right.
And look
you're
at his
a
face.
Fucking
look at
idiot.
His face.
He's had nothing to do with men cleaning his ass. He said, my asshole.
This guy is the biggest homophobe on this show.
Wow. He's got to be.
He on his show?
Yeah.
They emailed him and said, dude, you're a big homophobe on this show.
On this show. They said I'm homophobic and racist.
And racist. And you totally are, dude. You're such a homophobe on this show and racist.
I thought you just
on
no,
your
I'm
show.
Not
you're a little bit more like you know, real. You keep it real, keep but like it. On here,
come on, thug.
Dude. Yeah. On here, you're the biggest homophobic guy.
Really?
Yeah, for
well,
sure.
All I remember is that I Totes. Said that you guys all said if you had a gay son, you guys would be okay with it. I said it would bother me if he was the bottom. Like that's not that gay.
What?
No.
Yeah, remember? Yeah, you said you'd be okay with it, and you would let him redress.
I said
you.
He better be making lots of money if he's a bottom.
You didn't say all that at all.
Yeah,
no, you didn't.
I did. I specified.
No, we can listen to it again.
Look into it.
Booze and dudes, everybody. Tune in right
booze
now.
Booze and dudes, tune in. To who's the top and bottom.
Do your research on booze and dudes. I don't know. I don't know when I said it. I would have.
Exactly.
But I'm telling you, I would have had a problem. I know I had to have said
not
look,
at all.
If he's gay,
that's probably new to you.
As long
as
he's making
he's
money.
He's probably being gay right now, and you're like, oh, dude.
As long as
this.
He's making money while being gay, I don't care.
That's all that matters.
As long as he's making money.
Where are we sitting as far as time?
Paid to
no,
fucking
no
fuck, dudes.
Look, young Jamie,
hashtag
where are we sitting as far as time?
No hobo homo.
We're good, dude. We're only like at 30 minutes. We're killing it, bro. Are we live?
Homo?
We do have some guests next week. No, we're not live. No. We do got some guests next week. We got the famous promoter, wrestling promoter, the godfather of Southern
California
professional wrestling. Jesse Hernandez is going to be live in studio.
Who's that?
I don't know who's that.
In a couple weeks, guys.
He's the Vince McMahon of Southern California.
He really? Is. He is the it? Godfather of, huh? of indie wrestling in
like
Southern California.
Like from San Diego to Baker?
San Diego to, yeah, about Baker. The thing that the reason we suck his dick right now, or at least I am,
damn.
Is his promotion.
You're gobbling the whole knob.
Yes, has been running straight for 30 years.
Obviously not that straight if he's sucking dick. That's pretty gay.
Or no, I said I'm sucking dick.
Yeah, I know, but that's pretty gay.
Yeah, enough anyways, sucking dick.
God, you're so gay.
Exactly.
So gay.
Not
God,
straight.
Let it go, bro.
But anyways.
Jeez, bro, you're a douche. I'm heteroflexible. That doesn't mean anything about gay.
But no, he's successfully ran a promotion for over 30 years, and that's kind of a very big feat in the independent wrestling.
What's his real name, though?
Did he molest you too, or no?
No. I know his real name. I'm not going to say it on the radio, though.
So more
on the radio.
More proof to anyone out there.
The radio.
Hey, look,
it's such a piece of shit.
More proof to all you guys out there. You need a fake name because the odds are your mom or dad gave you a shit name that you don't like using.
You don't like your name,
like Jesse Hernandez. Like his mom and dad gave him.
We'll
a shit
We'll get into all that. I mean, like I said, I'm excited to have him.
Look,
for being
his
on
real
the
name
show.
Is Jesse. Like,
yeah, but
name.
I go by Dick Sassy because, look, let's face it, my mom's not very good at
who
picking
fucking
names.
Cares what his real fucking name
yeah,
is?
I care.
Pull it out of your fucking ass.
It's probably not very catchy.
Shut the fuck up, Scarlett.
Is his real name very catchy?
Well, listen to that episode. No. You'll find out his real name.
Thank you.
You'll find out his real name, and we'll find out why he changed his name. We'll do all that shit. It's going to be fun.
Larry Leibowitz.
You said you wanted a haircut. We're going to fucking cut your hair.
Fucking Hector Leibowitz. Keep it
she's
in their pants.
Of course you would, SG.
She's not a mom, dude.
I'm not surprised. Yeah, she's You'd really fuck pop star Nemo if I let you.
Yes. No, I would not, dude.
Are you kidding me? Look at those eyes.
Yeah, those are beautiful.
Yeah,
fucking
you were the one looking in her
eyes.
Look at
that bar meat. I don't want to look at his dick and his fucking unitard, dude. The fucking viewers saw what I saw.
That's how you know you're gay, because you're afraid to look at dick.
So Halloween's coming up.
He looks like
all right, order.
He looks like the Jenner that would ask you to
cut. Order. So Halloween's coming up, gents. Halloween's coming up. What are we gonna be? Are we doing this? Are we doing this podcasting in full costume, or what are we doing?
I don't know, man.
So the story, DK Murphy came up to me a couple months ago and said, "Hey, I think we should be the YMCA."
And he's calling me gay, and you want to be the village people.
This episode should be called "I Didn't Realize Everyone I Knew Was Gay." Holy shit! The closet's bigger than
DK
I thought.
DK Murphy has something to say.
Wait a minute, you like dick? You like dick? Wow, we should hang out.
Yeah,
we love dick.
Did we all just become best friends again?
John Stamos. Yeah.
Well, I'm going to chop this episode up a lot, so add some special effects to it. But anyways, so, I mean, is this something we're going to do, or are we just going independent? What do you think?
Okay, so how many people do we have? That's the real question.
Five, and there are six village people.
So I can make Wyatt a village people.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, that'd be cool,
dude.
And there was the idea that actually we would all come here and not put
yeah, not come in uniform. And then
we'd all get together, and then we do like a little dance for like maybe a minute or two.
Yeah,
and
that's when the song comes on. That's our intro. Yeah, we'd have our own intro.
Oh, shit.
Kind of like from Wayne's World 2.
Oh, shit.
I like it. Because if not, if we're not going to do that, I'm going to come as the Addams Family.
Just you?
Just the whole Addams Family?
No, just like me and Kayla, and then we'll have the baby, and we'll say we adopted
So you guys are going to do what we
Wednesday
did.
Wednesday, and the other fat went out.
Or you could be
you bringing your family?
No.
No, he could be the third. Remember the third one?
I already did that. Me and my whole family did Hubert? That.
You're not bringing your family, are you?
Yeah,
of course.
That's what I'm saying. I got to bring the. Yeah. I got to dress the
free
Wyatt
food,
up.
Bro.
No, here, check it out.
He's gonna be pissed.
Check it out.
Free food.
No. In Adam's family, I'm gonna dress Wyatt. You know what? In Adam's Family Values, had a baby.
I remember that. That's what I'm saying.
It was called Pubert.
Oh, that's his name, Pubert.
Yeah, we dressed him like that.
That's what I was saying.
It was originally a girl.
You're on Wednesday and Pugsley.
No, I'm saying all. I'm gonna listen to the podcast.
I was Pugsley. My wife was Wednesday.
I'm gonna tell people I adopted them out.
I see
that way I only have the baby as like a little Gomez because I got nothing else. That or
so then you could dress up as fucking Fester and you could have your wife dress up as what was her name in part two?
Dementia.
Here's what I want to go with Joan Cusack.
Oh, that was
Debbie. And then that way you could have the baby like you stole it.
Fuck that. I say we go with, I don't know, he's doing whatever party. This party's open, right?
Yeah.
It is.
Well, I like the village people.
If
idea.
You come out as Popstar Nemo, though, I'm going to lose my shit.
Oh, my God.
Oh, we're going to lose I'm going to lose my shit.
I would be Popstar Nemo. I would have no problem being Popstar Nemo.
I will fucking. But Richard looks like him, kind
of. He won't be able to look me in the eyes if I do.
Richard,
it.
I will die.
Yeah. I'll do it, bro.
Oh, my God. You will win.
I will fucking do it.
Because you want to know why? All of Michelle's family knows who Popstar Nemo is.
Do they?
Because we make fun of him every campsite we do.
Really?
We play his fucking shit, just laugh our ass off.
My hair ain't long anymore, so I have to get a wig.
Oh, that's right.
But it'd be a cheap costume. It'd be a leotard and a wig.
Yeah, I'll do the wig. I don't give a fuck. I'll do it.
Yeah.
You have a
5 o'clock shadow, and you're set, dude.
But I still say
that's
I like
so
the
fucking funny.
I like the village people idea. I'm just saying.
It is, but it is, you know. Good. But the thing is, if you're all the village people, it'd be tough to give out a trophy because. We were all the village
people.
What
are you talking about? That's group fucking.
Yeah, best group.
There's no best group.
Oh, we'll start one.
There's best no male, best female.
Rig that shit and we fucking win, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, okay.
And then whoever went the
that's
best
true,
out
I
of
run
all
that
us.
Shit out.
Yeah, duh.
We win all the awards all the time.
Yeah.
We win best female. Like, thanks.
And also,
hey, who gives a fuck?
It could just be who looks the most like the village people. You know, who looks
Carol,
more like
what are you
right,
come
the
as?
Best like the
village. Mama Bucks, what are you going to come as this Halloween? No. Bullshit.
She said nothing.
Bull to the shit.
I'm moving. B.
Damn.
To the S.
I'm moving, she said.
She's moving, not before Halloween, you ain't.
Hell to the
You're
no,
not moving before no, Halloween. Not before Halloween. No. Mom, she, what are you going to be?
Yeah, exactly.
Give us a little hint.
The parrot.
What oh, shit, parrot? That's right.
Oh, what from Aladdin?
No.
No, because huh? This is a pirate theme. Halloween party.
And we're being the gay YMCA.
But you can be anybody.
I didn't even know that.
No. That means you're butt pirates.
No, no.
I didn't realize.
No. We can be anything.
No, but we can still be that because that's
but
butt
the
pirates.
Party
oh, but the party decorations.
Decorations are. Thank you. Decorations is pirates.
Yeah, we're well, still butt pirates. I should vote. Well, yeah, that's pretty
what
gay.
What is Brett? Because I like
The Caribbean.
Oh. So why don't we just be all fucking Johnny Depp before he got arrested where he's crying?
What if we're all just different Johnny Depp?
Yeah.
We're all versions of Johnny Depp.
We all should.
Oh,
Crybaby Edward Scissorhands.
Yeah.
Oh, bad as fuck. Great.
Oh, yeah, dude.
All right.
Do that then? Fuck it.
All right, what's Johnny Depp? Are you going to be, Joe?
I might go messed up in
the... I was going to say the ugly one.
Wow, you piece of shit. You horrible.
Such a piece of shit. You know, when he's on one, he's on one.
Yeah, I know. Young Jamie's had too many.
Young Jamie, when he's on one, he's on one.
Not your daddy's root beer.
I don't know who I'd be. Maybe I'd go messed up and be Tonto.
Well, okay.
That was
Tonto.
Not as funny.
Yeah. That was pull a fun up movie. On Google. Who's Tonto?
That's fucking Lone Ranger.
Lone Ranger.
Yeah, oh, I looked that up for me. I don't
really?
Remember.
Tonto, jump on it.
Surprisingly good movie, actually.
Yeah.
And dude,
Tonto, huh?
I liked it. I thought it was a fun
yeah,
movie.
It was really good, dude.
Lone Ranger was fucking really? Fun, dude.
Yeah. As much as people talk shit about it, it was awesome, dude.
Lone Ranger.
Oh, that's dope.
Lone Ranger
I've
to me is what Wild Wild West is trying to be.
That's pretty cool.
Well, what makes it messed up is that he's supposed to be Native American, and I'm not.
He actually is Native, though.
Oh, what the
Johnny Depp, I mean.
Fuck
yeah, he's Native, Native to America.
I get it. That's
we
good.
All are.
Yeah, we all are.
Oh, shit.
What are you talking about? No, we're not.
Dude, I was born here.
That's not Native.
Were you born here?
That's not Native.
Yeah, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. Native.
No, Native
look up the
means
word.
Like
Native.
Culture. Yeah, it look
is
it
Native.
Up.
That's not look up the word Native. I ain't making it up, guys.
He's making it out like that your whole generation was from here. No, you weren't.
I didn't
like,
say two that.
We're
I didn't
Native
say,
and we're American.
I'm saying I'm Native to here. I'm not
yeah,
saying
but they were
my
Indian from
was.
India, so there's a difference.
No. Let's not get all SJW. I'm saying...
Well, I don't give a fuck about that.
I'm saying... I'm Native. I don't care what anybody else
no.
says.
You're
I
you?
Born
Native,
here.
I'm you're Native San Bernardino.
Native, and that's the bottom line.
San Bernardino, so not it. Fucking like fucking Mexico.
Or
so
America.
All in favor of DK. I'm sorry. If Dick Sassy be a Native,
capital
say
U?
I.
No.
I.
That's two
he's
against
Native.
One. No, he didn't even vote for it.
America. I was born in America.
See, he's Merkin, dude. He's
are you
native.
Voting for you being Native or yes?
Yeah, I was born Merkin.
3-1.
That's different.
Listen, no, time out. Now, the term Native American means you were
already here before the boat came.
Yeah. No, but that's them.
No, look it up, dude.
All right, never mind. Fuck it. I don't
it's
care.
It's true. No, he's right about that. When you're native of when they named America, America
before
based
anybody
on,
founded it.
Based on why they named it.
Okay, let me ask you a question. Okay. If I go to England and they ask me, "Are you American?"
Yeah.
Doesn't that mean I'm a Native American?
No. Usually people in the pubs will say, "Hey, you a Yank?"
Yeah, you're a Yank.
You should know because
you
if you've been frequenting
yank.
Bars around Native, there, you should already know by
a Native
then.
Meant you were Indian when they thought it was
they're,
India.
They're going to fuck with you. They're going to go right away.
So speaking about Halloween, I took, you know, me, Michelle, and my young son, young Brandon, went to Disney, downtown Disney.
Well, his how name was is it? Young Buck.
So we went there, shit. Dude, and there was this fucking... I guess they have this Oogie Boogie Halloween thing.
Yeah, yeah.
So this fucking family, you know, all the families are dressing up alike, and it makes me sick to my stomach. In fact, it didn't make me sick. It made me want to shit, so I shit in a couple times in one of Mickey's toilets. And, dude, this whole family was dressed up as the Incredibles.
Oh
God, it was pathetic.
It was one of those fucking suckers, dude.
Dude, it was so pathetic. And then, like, I went a little further, and then there was, like, you know...
Were they hoping people took pictures with them?
Right?
Ooh. Like, no. Losers? Not yet. I mean, they didn't enter the park yet.
Really?
But it was so pathetic.
Oh.
Everyone was dressed in like stupid fucking costumes.
Yeah. Trying to get
like,
attention
man,
and shit.
This is like fucking gay.
Yeah, you're like, I thought Halloween was for kids,
this
not
probably
you.
This gotta take
fucking
shit over, guys, because the world's headed to hell.
Well, poor, you know, the sad part is, though, this is actually pretty funny. So we went to the gate, right? And here's a picture of us at the gate. Michelle sent it to me. I'll show it to you guys. We went to the gate, right?
We're showing it to the world or no? We're showing it to the world or no?
And look,
we're showing it to the
world. We didn't have any tickets.
Are you just standing there?
So it was a complete dick tease for Brandon. So he started to cry.
He said, "Fuck my
dad."
That's
fucked up, dude. You got
and then I went like this. I went, "Stop being a puss."
Wow. Yeah. That's the way to do it, dude. Hey,
that's how you got to do it.
Yo, this is why you don't go inside, because it's shit like this.
You can't get what you want all the time.
I said, "Listen, Brandon, I'll take you here, you know, on another day when we got more time to go in the park." But we don't have this is a special event that got sold out, and Disney itself is only open for 3 more hours. Yeah. So let's, you know, if we get something to eat,
why would that make any
fucking sense.
It doesn't. Yeah. And by the way, if you showed up there, it's only in hopes that someone canceled.
I said, I said, I'll take you your birthday month next month, you know, I'll take you for your birthday. He said, oh, thanks, Dad.
Well, here. More than that, what does Brandon want? Like, we could make his birthday really cool.
Pussy.
At the party.
He wants
fucking losers.
Pussy. So no, then pussy. I said, Brandon, I'll take you to Knott's Scary Farm right now. You know, it's only $1.50, and I'll take you to, you know, for all of us to go. Yeah,
veteran or something?
And I said, so up till 1 a.m.
Yeah, no, but I mean, veterans are free right now. So I was like,
and he said, no, it's
Brandon puts Elmer's glue on his face. He's like, old as fuck.
It's not Scary Farm. And he said, nah, Dad, I'm scared of that. Oh, I said, shit. Oh, fuck.
How old is this kid again?
So, well, you know what?
We got a
12 years old.
When he turns 14, dude, if he doesn't make it to fucking Universal,
no. I'm going to kick him out of here.
Yeah. That's what I mean.
No, but yeah, trick time.
Tell him,
Brandon's got to go with us to the grow up. Scariest coaster.
I've already done that.
Here, I'll grow up with those balls
on the coaster. We have to do a Booze and Dudes road trip where Brandon's our technician, and then he's going to ride
see every horrible
the scariest
thing
coaster, because every coaster after that ain't going to be shit.
That's what I told him.
Every coaster after that is nothing.
You got to get over the fucking scaries.
So I just looked up Johnny Depp's IMDb on like iconic costumes.
Oh,
okay, all right. Yeah,
yeah. Edward Scissorhands.
So I got to be Captain Jack since I'm the host.
Well, here,
let me
list these off and tell me what you guys think. So, right. Crybaby.
Awesome costume.
Yeah. Edward Scissorhands.
Crybaby. Awesome costume.
You don't remember Crybaby?
Look up Crybaby for me.
Are you fucking serious?
It's a 1950s John Waters costume, bro.
I don't remember this.
This is the first movie. God damn,
look it up for me, please.
No, we all know.
Because I got a few more.
This is a fucking beautiful movie.
Check it out. Canceled because you asked that.
You could do it. God damn it, man.
Yeah, we just watched it. What's Eating Gilbert Grape?
How are we bearing bad movies / anything?
Oh, check it out. Ed Wood, but you do Ed Wood and drag.
Yeah, I should come as Glenn, I should
come as a retard. Glendora or whatever?
Yeah, what the Glenn versus, I don't know. Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas.
Awesome costume.
That's just fun. You could be Crybaby.
Yeah, you never seen it?
Yeah, you don't put that much effort in your costume.
Of course, Captain Jack.
I have all that.
That's
Captain
you.
Jack Sparrow.
That'd be you.
I just need a motorcycle.
Then you do Captain Jack Sparrow or the Libertine. Or
yeah, that's kind of
Willy Wonka.
That's a badass costume.
Chuck would punch him in the face and be like, "Get the fuck out of here for ruining my fucking favorite movie."
That's not the real Willy Wonka.
Sweeney Todd. Oh yeah, that could be cool.
The Mad Hatter. Those are all.
Oh cool. Yeah, the Mad Hatter.
That's kind of gay.
It's a little gay.
It's a badass costume though.
I guess you could kind of do Dark Shadows, but that movie sucks.
Badass costume.
Lone Ranger.
Cool costume.
So, and I don't know if this would really count, but Tusk. He was in Tusk.
Was he?
Yeah, he was the guy with the dick nose.
You should do that.
Why are you guys hugging and high-fiving?
I think we found your costume.
No, if anything,
you don't need anything.
Waka, waka, waka.
Was you wearing a red shirt? You used to wear a red shirt.
I'm going to be any of the giant. You know what we should do, though?
That's fine. Here's the thing. What we got to do is play a prank on the whole party. And then send them out the same costume to everybody. Everyone should be Captain Jack.
Okay.
And then we all come as someone else.
I love it. Like, hey, listen, this is the theme of the party. This is what you're assigned. You're assigned this. Everyone's going to be Captain Jack, right? So we'll have all the men be Captain Jack Sparrow, and there'll be like 30 of them.
They all look retarded and shit. What was that?
They'll all make fun of each other.
We'll make sure that they don't. It'll say in the letter, "Don't tell anybody else your costume." Right. And then all the girls will be like, you know, one costume.
At the door, we'll give everyone a password. Oh. What's your password? Captain Jack.
And everyone just shows up as Captain Jack.
They go into a backyard full of Captain Jacks.
Oh, fuck.
What was the big dick nose guy?
That'd be so fucking funny.
I don't know. From Tusk, Johnny Depp.
Okay, cool. I want to see it. Okay, I never saw that movie.
Don't, please.
Oh, I know. That's what I heard from everybody. Yeah, Joe just needs a hat.
Oh, Joe, that is you. Joe, that's you. Hey, show that on the camera. Show the people that.
Okay. Gee, thanks a lot, guys.
Yeah, fuck you guys.
Yeah, that's definitely you.
So see this one.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Damn. Right here. Oh, shit. Oh, shit, that is you.
Again, you guys are monsters.
By monsters, he means funny.
Shit.
The angels who fell.
What are we saying?
Angels who fell.
The angels that fell.
The angels that fell and said,
we had nowhere else to go.
I feel the like angels that said, fook.
Yeah. I feel like that's our biker name. Hurrum.
You like that?
Yeah. Chucks a cocktail. That's what it's bringing.
Angels who fell. I feel like that's our biker name.
The angels that fell?
Yeah.
And said, ow.
All right. Angels, anything else, folks?
We're the angels who fook.
The angels who fook.
We're the angels that fuck shit up.
What if I get the trademark on it?
You should. Oh, that'd be fucked up.
That's so fucking funny.
You wait a year and you're like,
do it.
Do it.
I don't like that you're looking
anyways.
At your phone now.
I know. Anything else, gents?
We're dead.
I had my fun, so I'm good.
So make sure you guys.
Was there a highlight for the week, dude? You normally have a highlight of the week, man.
The Crew Network will launch very soon. The Bizarre and Unexplained, we're going to have the first episode by mid-October.
Hell yeah.
Okay. And we got a whole lot of shit going on. Yeah. And the Johnny Martin, I guess, is supposed to return soon. I don't know. He said that he's going to try to make arrangements and be here.
Around December.
In December. Oh, December.
He's buying us all Christmas gifts.
We might,
he's going to buy us a Christmas gift.
With his job money. Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah.
So, well.
Hey! No, I'm saying.
We hope to do a new intro for you involving, I don't know, a little hint, the Fuller House.
Ooh.
Might be the fullest house you've ever seen.
The fullest of all houses.
Cool. Yeah. We need to find just the music.
You'll see our kids. You'll see all kinds of crazy shit.
That's going to be hilarious.
Very cute. Seen him on Facebook yesterday.
Which
God
one?
Is precious.
Which one?
Guys.
Fat little dude.
Oh, dude, he's the best. He just turned 6 months.
Kidding me?
Yeah.
I just heard a half year thing. I was
like, oh. Yeah. Oh, yeah, dude.
I'm Chuck Bucks.
Signing off
all you motherfuckers.
Fucking peace.
Bye, everybody.
Fuck this, dude. Let's fucking do a karaoke song. What are we doing?
What?
Yeah, dude.
Okay.
What are we doing?
I Will Find You by Clannad.
What? No.
Yeah, it's a good song. It's a beautiful song.
What? Okay, karaoke what?
Karaoke.
Come on.
Something Queen, bro.
Oh, Queen?
Everyone knows Queen. Karaoke Queen. If you don't like Freddie Mercury, you're a piece of shit.
What was that? Don't Stop Me Now?
That's a good one.
Oh, Can't Stop Me or something?
Go to YouTube.
Show Must Go On, bro.
Googling Freddie Mercury. Karaoke.
Queen.
Hey, you ever Google anything?
Yeah, no. Bro. I'm
Google does not work, bro.
I thought this guy used a computer.
Every Jesus time I ask Google, I say, Google, how long do I have left?
Queen karaoke. Just put karaoke. Okay,
Google never responds to me with the right answer. It's always like, Rich, I don't know how long you have left. You have to let me know.
Not put you in Rhapsody.
Yeah, no.
Don't Stop Me Now, you said?
Nah, that's pretty gay.
Don't Stop Me Now?
Live Aid, because he had AIDS. No, that's also just pretty that one. Disrespectful.
Do you want Don't Stop Me Now?
Or you guys, whatever you guys want. I'm singing with you faggots.
All right, there we go.
All right. Make a big screen.
Oh, okay.
Don't stop.
Start it off, Joe.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. And the world, I'll turn it inside out. I'm floating around in ecstasy.
Slow it down.
Don't stop me now. Don't stop me. Cause I'm having a good time. Having a good time. I'm a shooting star. Leaping through the sky. Like a tiger. Defying the laws of gravity. I'm a
racing car. Passing by like
Lady Godiva. Fast.
Going, go, go, go. There's no stopping me. Burning through the sky.
Yeah.
200 degrees. They call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I want to make a supersonic man out of you. Stop me now, I'm having such a good time. I'm having a ball, don't stop me now. If you want to have a good time, just give me a call. Don't stop me now, I'm having a good time. Having a good time, if I'm having a good time, I don't want to stop at all. I'm a rocket ship on my way to Mars, on a collision course. I'm a satellite, I'm out of control. I'm a sex machine ready to reload. Get out of bum, about to explode. I'm burning through the sky. Yeah. 200 degrees, it's what they call me, Mr. Fahrenheit.
COVID.
I'm traveling at the speed of light.
Yeah, I want to make a supersonic man out of you.
Woman.
Don't stop me.
Don't stop me. Don't stop me. Don't stop me.
Don't stop me.
Don't stop me.
Don't stop me.
Don't stop me. Have a good time. Have a good time. Don't stop me.
Stop me.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Fuck it. We're done, right?
Who's in this podcast? Thank you for listening. Go to the Crew Network. Soon we're going to launch. The Crew Network coming after you, motherfuckers. See you later.
Get it. Get it.